سلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. In these days, in the lands of Mecca and also Medina, millions of people now are heading to the lands known as Mecca and Medina to perform the Hajj, the fifth pillar of Islam. So you can see now, alhamdulillah, many people, different colors, different nations, all having one thing in common. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. There's no God but Allah, and Muhammad is the messenger. And this is the inclusiveness of this religion, that people come now once a year. Millions of people go to the lands of Mecca and Medina to perform the Hajj and to visit the holy sites and to visit our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam in Medina. And these days are known as the days of Ashr al-Hijjah. These days, these 10 days now in which we are in, 10 days, the first 10 days of this month of the Hijjah are days which Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned in the Quran. According to some of the ulama, in Surah Al-Fajr, Allah swears by the dawn break, Al-Fajr, and in the 10 nights. And the ulama say, what are these 10 nights? And the ulama say, these are the 10 nights of the Hijjah. So Allah has sworn as an oath, something great, because Allah only swears by great things. So he swore by Al-Fajr, the dawn break, and then the 10 nights. These 10 nights. So this is something great with Allah. What's so great in these 10 nights? Many hadith talk about these 10 days and these nights. And one hadith mentions that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, there's no days more blessed to worship Allah in and more beloved, أحبوا إلى الله, more beloved to Allah to worship in these 10 days. These 10 days are very important, inshaAllah. And according to some, a day or two now have gone. So you have less than 10 days now. And in these days, it is recommended that we fast. In one hadith we mentioned in the Arabic Khutbah, that if someone fasts one of these days now, before the day of Eid, okay, you fast tomorrow, for example, or Sunday, or Monday, or Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday. Friday, we'll talk about in a second, inshallah. We fast Saturday or Sunday. It is if you fasted one whole year. You fast Saturday, you make an intention of going to fast. Don't eat anything from the Fajr to Maghrib. It is if you've not fasted one whole year. Now, if you have days of Ramadan to make up, you or your family, then fast one day and make the intention to fast 2 days. So by fasting Saturday, you have the intention to fast the day of Ashr al-Hijjah and make an intention also to make up a day of Ramadan. So you do two intentions and do one act of worship, you gain two rewards. Some of the ulama said this is permissible. You do one act of worship, have two intentions, and you gain a lot of reward. 1 year, and if you fast Sunday, that's 2 years. And if you fast Monday, 3 years. If you fast Tuesday, 4 years. Thursday, 5 years. And then when you get to Friday, Friday's a different day altogether. Friday is the day of Arafah, which we'll talk about in a second, inshaAllah ta'ala. And another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also mentioned that do a lot of remembrance of Allah, a lot of dhikr. And the Prophet specifically mentioned a tahleel, saying, La ilaha illallah in these days. La ilaha illallah. And saying the word subhanallah and saying the word alhamdulillah. These words specifically the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned. And any type of remembrance of Allah, whether reading the Quran or doing da'wah or whatever else. But don't let these days be like normal days. At the very least, fast, inshaAllah ta'ala. And then on the Friday, next Friday, we want you to fast. Next Friday, inshaAllah, everybody should be fasting for those who are able to fast. And mashaAllah. Short hours. Fajr now is very, very early, alhamdulillah. Not late at night. And Maghrib now, mashallah, getting earlier and earlier. Fast. If you fast next Friday, inshallah, which we'll talk about next khutbah, it's as if your previous sins have been forgiven and your upcoming year's sins are forgiven when you fast in Mu'arifah, which is this Friday, inshaAllah ta'ala. So these are days of fasting, inshaAllah. Very short days. Alhamdulillah. And subhanAllah. We need to make a lot of dua, inshaAllah. When we're fasting, our prayers are more closer to an answer, to be answered by Allah, inshaAllah. These are the days where we're seeing now much fitna now happening around the Muslim world, where people are claiming to follow Islam, are doing things against Islam, are doing things which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not commit, killing innocent people because of their madhab or because of their political allegiances, or then killing minorities because they're not following your understanding of Islam, despite them living there for centuries, and then trying to kill people who are going over there to help, going over there taking supplies from here and going to help the brothers and sisters there, inshallah. And now people, now these khawarij, these extremists now are going to now to use him as a tadhiya. يوم الحج, the day of Hajj, we slaughter animals, we don't slaughter people. But this is the khawarij, these are the extremists. And these, we have to be very careful protecting our masajid and protecting our young people from extremists. And like I said before, these extremists, they begin very, very small steps. They're not going to jump to big things. They start small things, they start small steps. They start telling you, don't go to this mosque, don't pray behind this imam. These are steps, these are seeds of the extremists. Whether you believe me or not, whether you believe me, this is the beginning. Okay, you should be careful from our young people listening, whether they're listening to people talking, or listening to people on the internet, or reading books that encourage Muslims to call other Muslims kafir. I found some books, la ilaha illallah, subhanAllah, recently I found some books where they're encouraging you to call the people kufar. Everything I've talked about in these khutbas, these books I recently found, talking the opposite. Quoting the Quran and quoting the hadith. And quoting how the Prophet, no, the Prophet didn't mean these Muslims, it meant something else. Trying to change the Quran, the verse of the Quran, to suit their understanding. These books, now you get them free. We don't want any books in this masjid talking about calling other Muslims kafir. Please don't give me these books. Don't bring any books in the masjid what you're talking about calling other Muslims kafir, or showing intolerance to other people. We don't want it. Take yourself and take your books and go somewhere else. We don't need it, wallahi. We don't need you or your books. Now we have the Quran. Quran is very clear. Very clear in how to deal with other people. We have the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you're going to come now with your books and your pamphlets and your leaflets. Okay, we don't need you, your books, or your pamphlets, or any of your khawarij ideas. Go take yourself and go somewhere else. Inshallah, we have to be honest. These things now, you can pick these things up. You can find them here and there. And it's enough that some of our boys have gone away to these countries. And Allah protect them and look after their families. And bring them back, inshallah, and live in a safe place. But hey, you can find now, you can go on the internet, you find things now. People saying you can do this, you can do that. You can call the Muslims kafir. You have to pray behind this one. You don't have to pray behind this one. This is any at-tafarruq. Spitting, dividing between the Muslims. In this masjid, alhamdulillah, you can come. Any madhab, come. But if you're going to use the mosque to play around, you can use the prayer to play around. You're going to use, these people, subhanAllah, I look at some people and think, what are these people trying to do? Yeah. Who are they trying to fool? Are we stupid? Do we look stupid to you, brother? Really? But these people, they come on the cause, indirect. We weren't born yesterday. Maybe you were born yesterday, perhaps. Allah alam, maybe you were born yesterday. Maybe you started reading about Islam and grown a beard, and then khalas, and now you're an alam, maybe you don't know anything at all about Islam. But we're not stupid. Okay? We're not stupid at all. So we're going to protect, inshallah, this masjid as Sheikh Sa'id and the ulama of the past. And if the people follow what the previous people were like before, Al Udaini, Sheikh Sa'id, Sayyid Hashim, Sheikh Hassan Al-Sama'il, oh, mashallah, these people, how they were before, and some of you know them. Did you hear any of them calling on the Muslims kafir? Did Did you hear them calling people to extremism? Did you hear them pushing the young people to do bad things? No. How did they deal with other Muslims?
Very good.
Even the Muslims they differed with, they dealt with okay. How did they deal with people who weren't Muslim?
Okay.
They even married people from families who weren't Muslim. On the day of Eid, they used to march in the streets here. And the children who weren't Muslim, you say, this is Arab Eid. Arab Christmas, they say. Arab Christmas, the young people who weren't Muslim. And some of this family grew up to be Muslim, alhamdulillah. Barakah. This is the way of the Yemenis. In particular, the Yemenis, you want to talk about history? The Yemeni people, they were the one who spread Islam around the world. You go to Indonesia, and you go to Malaysia, and Singapore, and Brunei, the Yemenis were the ones that took Islam then. How did they take? With a sword? No. Takfir? No. Bid'ah and shirk? No. Don't pray behind this imam, pray behind this imam? No. They went with rahmah. They went with the sunnah. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned the people of Yemen more. At all the places, there's many hadith talking about people of Yemen. Because what the Prophet saw, he saw the hearts are very soft. And this is not something specific to the people of Yemen, but the Prophet saw something in the people of Yemen, he made dua. And he made dua, Allah ibarik fi Shamna wa Yemen. Oh Allah bless the lands of Sham and Yemen. And now we're seeing fitna in the lands of Sham and Yemen. May Allah protect Yemen, inshaAllah, from those who want to cause problems, and protect Sham and lift the mashakil that's coming there, and protect all our lands, inshaAllah ta'ala. So as I'm going back, fast these days, and next Friday, fast Friday, and come to the khutbah, and I'll tell you what you'll achieve by fasting the Friday, inshaAllah ta'ala, Yawm Arafah, and what's going to happen on Yawm Arafah, inshaAllah ta'ala, when thousands, millions upon millions of people will be in Mecca, in the place of Arafah, and we're here fasting, inshaAllah ta'ala. We'll talk about what's going to happen, and what the great reward for those who fast next Friday, inshaAllah ta'ala. So fast next Friday, and fast these days as well, before Friday, inshaAllah, begin with the Lord. عباد الله يعلمون أنه لا أحد إنسان في هذا الزمان من الإنسان